back, and now we go to the air. And while this is not a promise of comfort, it may get you a better price. Believe it or not, there is a day of the week and a time of day when buying airline tickets saves you the most money. The same way airlines try to reduce flying to a science, consumers can now use that science to their own advantage. NBC's Tom Costello covers aviation for us and has tonight's report.
Mid-morning at LAX, where Daisy Ellingson and her family were returning to Minneapolis, but the trip wasn't cheap.
It was frustrating because we thought, okay, we're gonna do a really inexpensive trip, and $340, that's not too bad at all. But then in the end, when you're paying $500.
Experts say there is a strategy to saving money. Start looking at airfares 3 months before you want to travel. The perfect moment to buy? Tuesday at 3 p.m. after airlines cut fares and competitors match prices on as many as 20,000 flights a day. The cheapest days to travel? Tuesday, Wednesday, and Saturday when there are fewer business travelers.
The number one mistake people make when they're buying airline tickets is procrastinating.
Whatever you do, avoid buying a ticket within 7 days of departure when business travelers will pay top dollar. Just look at the prices from Washington Reagan to San Francisco. Fly next Sunday, it'll cost $1,149 round trip. Book now, fly in 2 weeks, $877. Leave in 3 weeks, the price drops to $742. But pay for a trip 7 weeks away, you can go for $465, a $684 savings.
If you ask a person in the aircraft actually raise their hand and ask how much they paid, you'd see clusters of people that paid different price points depending on what day they bought, when they bought it, what day they're traveling.
You can even save money if you fly hungry before breakfast and during lunch and dinner when planes aren't as full. And while everyone prefers to fly nonstop, you can often save up to 50% if you make a connection and have a layover, sacrificing time for savings. The most expensive day to fly, Sunday. Seats are often full with vacationers flying home. As for holiday travel,
probably just gonna be in the Minnesota cold all winter.
If you can, book now. Tom Costello, NBC News, Washington.